This study, again by a government, gave us a lot of understanding about the Indian economy. So that is how we started moving to other parts of India, studying different aspects, different economic activities, from small activities to larger economic activities. So that is how people like us came to realize that Indian economic system is a different system. You know, you cannot study this in textbook. Textbook do not teach the functioning realities. For example, if you see the Indian economy, you will understand that it is dominated by families. It is the families that dominate Indian economy. All of us know 2/3 of our national income comes from the corporate sector. Non-corporate sector. Corporate sector contributes about 14 to 15%. Government sector contributes about 20 plus percentage. About 2/3 comes from the non-corporate sector, and non-corporate sector is completely dominated by families. It is the families that run the non-corporate sector, SME sector, whatever may be the businesses. Even in the corporate sector, all of us may be knowing, in India, more than 90-95% of the corporate sector again is dominated by families. So families play a huge role in Indian economy. But when we study Indian economics as a subject, do we study about the role of families? No economic teacher, no economic textbooks mentions about the role of families. And this is an important fact that we have to understand. So whatever we study, the Western economic theories, whether it is communist theories or Western capitalist theories, they treat people as individuals. Individuals. So the modern economic theories, so-called modern theories of the West, they consider people as an individual. Even a child, according to the neoliberalist economic theory, is considered as only a consumer, is a consumer. So everybody is an individual. But here in India, there is no individual at all. Nobody could be called as individual. Everybody is part of the family. So it is the families that dominate the Indian economy, but unfortunately, we do not study about it. This is just an example. So when we went to different parts of country, we understood that India is largely dominated by families. Families with their own traditional background, with their own experience, knowledge gained over a period of years, they know economics better than the teachers like us, than professors like us. We realized this. In fact, when we go and meet people, even ordinary people, uneducated people, ladies, elderly people, they know much better economics than many of the textbooks put together. We have seen in many places as to how this works. We conducted a study in Coimbatore about 10-12 years back in flower market, Coimbatore flower market. And in Coimbatore flower market, the flower vendors are mostly ladies, and they don't have money at that time even to buy flowers that they sell every day. So early morning they come to the market with just only baskets in their hands. They come to the market, and because they don't have money, they go to the other side. A financier would be waiting. They go and borrow 1,000 rupees every day in the market from him. Go to the other side, buy the requirements for the day, flowers for 1,000 rupees. By about 1-1:30, they would have sold all their flowers, thereby making a profit of, you know, some 300-350 rupees per day. So 1:30, again the financier would come. These people would go and repay their money along with the interest. You know, high rates of interest, 100 rupee per day for 1,000 rupees. So they would repay 1,000 plus interest. Balance, they have about 250 or so. By 2 o'clock, a chit fund wala will come. They will give him 100 rupees every day. So every day they were saving 100 rupees. And they go back to their families' homes only with 100 or 150. In fact, they do not take the entire money back home. They were saving 100 rupees per day. At that time, we calculated in the main Coimbatore flower market alone, every year, these ladies were saving 7,30,000 rupees approximately. So one market, one place, so-called uneducated elderly ladies selling flowers, they were saving so much money. If you calculate the money that is saved in other flower markets, it will run into several crores. That is how in India people save money. It is not through this modern education. They all know that saving is part of our life. They have to save money because in India we have systems that were thrust into our minds since several centuries, generations. So these people save money, and this is how, you know, savings habit is there throughout the country. We have seen across the country different walks of life, whether one is a very ordinary uneducated lady or a person in modern business, they all save money. And this is how we started understanding our economy. So once we started studying this, our respect for Indian economy, respect for India, respect for our traditions and culture increased many, many times. In fact, based on our experience, I would even say that it is the Indian culture, it is the Indian traditions that remain as the foundation for all our economic development. So this experience you would get only when we go and study. This you cannot get through textbooks. Even if I explain this, you may not be able to understand fully. Once you go to one or two, three places and then interact with the people, find out what is their background, how they entered into different businesses, different economic activities, what were their motivating factors, and how are they sustaining in their businesses, then you will understand that there are many unseen forces that are working behind them. And these unseen forces are, could be explained through what we call Indian economic models. You know, these models are explicit, but when you go and see behind it, the reasons for it, then you will understand the reasons are rooted in our culture, in our tradition, in our backgrounds.